Now it's time to make these tabs do the correct switching. So currently, when we click on the tabs, we know that the event is being heard, but we need the tab itself to switch and the tab content to switch. If we look in our code, you can see that the tab that is currently active has a class of active applied to the H3, as well as a class of active applied to the div, which contains the content for that particular tab. What we want to do is when the user clicks on the tab, we want to move this active class to the tab that was clicked. And we want to move both the active class on the H3 and on the tab content. Let's go into our JavaScript. I'm going to get rid of this comment since we don't need this anymore. And what we're going to do is we're going to take some action inside of our function for activate tab. We want to move the class around, and we're going to be using the same event listener every time. There's a couple of things that we need to do in order to make this work. We're going to be using the concept in JavaScript of the keyword this. This in JavaScript means basically whatever we are acting on at the present moment. So in the context of an event listener, we're talking about the thing that heard the event. In this case, it's our tab header. So what we're going to do is we're going to use the fact that every tab header has an ID, which if we look back up here in our code, every tab header has a class of tab header, and then it has an ID of tab-header-3. This is a unique name that is particular to each of the tabs. Now, the divs also have ID names, and the ID names are almost identical with the exception of the middle word. So these ID names match with the exception of this one word. The word tab is in there and the digit is in there, as well as the dashes. This is a key concept because what we're going to do is when the user clicks on the header, we're going to inspect the ID and we're going to change it to this, and then we can move the active class to the corresponding content. And we can do that using the this keyword. So we're going to collect the ID in a variable. Let's go ahead and create a variable called myID. I'm going to store this inside of my active tab function, and I'm going to make the variable called myID equal to this.id. So what that means is we're collecting the ID of our own header. So to show that this is actually working, I'm going to have my console display the results of myID. Because this is a variable, I no longer need the quotes. If I save this and we go out to the browser and we refresh, when I click on the tabs, you can see that it's giving me the ID name of that header tab. So if I click on the third one, it's going to say tab header 3. If I click on the first one, it's going to say tab header 1. This is kind of handy because we can see the actual state of the variable at the time that the code is executing. So now that we have this, we're going to create another variable. I'm going to change the semicolon to a comma so that I can create another variable. And our new variable is going to be called content ID. And content ID is going to be equal to the value of my ID, and then we're going to use the replace method. The replace method is a method that's built into JavaScript and it can act on strings. So we're going to take the ID name, and the replace method takes two arguments. The first one is what I want to search for. In this case, that's header. The second argument is what I want to replace it with. So in this case, it's going to be content. So again, I'm taking this string and I'm going to replace the word header with the word content, and I'm assigning it to a variable called content ID. So if I put the content ID inside of my console and we save and we go look in the browser, instead of now giving us the name of the header in which we click, when we click these buttons, it's going to give us the name of the corresponding content div. So this is great. So the next thing we need to do is we need to move that class around. We're going to go ahead and use getElementById to do that. I'm going to get rid of the console log comment, and we'll use document.getElementById and I'm going to use my variable for my ID and set the class name to be equal to tab header and also active. So I want to go ahead and move both the class names of tab-header and active to whatever the activated tab is. We're going to use this same method. I'm just going to copy this in again. On the second getElementById, I need to get the content ID and I want to use the class name property, but I want the tab to be tab content, not tab header, and then we'll also add the active class. So when the function is going to be run, it's going to trigger our event, and now we're going to be applying the class names to the header and the div with the ID of tab content. If I save this and we refresh in the browser, when I click on the tabs, you can see that the CSS styling for the active tab is being applied. In addition, the tab content is displaying. This isn't working quite how we want it to, and we'll fix it in just a minute, but you can see that when I do click my tabs, the active state is being applied on both the header and on the div. The thing that's not happening right now is it's not removing that active class name from the one that was previously clicked. So we'll be doing that in the next exercise.